This is my favorite Pokemon card.
And one way to keep it safe is to make it larger and then make it invisible.
Whoa!
This is all 100% real. I didn't use any movie magic at all. Just science. But it gets even crazier. When I draw something on the outside of the bag with a permanent marker and put it in water, the inside disappears, but the outside remains. Wanna know what's happening? Then let's get science. What? Oh no! Whoa! If you don't believe the Pokemon card really disappeared, you can try it at home using a container or bowl of water, a Ziploc bag, some pieces of paper, and a permanent marker. Start by drawing something on the paper. I'm using a cartoon version of myself, but you can draw whatever you want. Place your drawing in a Ziploc bag and make sure it's completely closed. Lastly, fill a bowl or a container with water. The only trick is to look at this from the correct angle. If you look at it from the front, it won't disappear. Aww. You need to look at it from about this angle or from anywhere in this area. Yay! So how does this work? To explain it, I'm going to use my childhood train set. Whoa! I haven't used this for years. 2 hours later. And a little bit of snow. And Simon's settlement is complete. All aboard, next stop is Chocolate Canyon. All right, the science. Let's pretend this train is a beam of light and this dinosaur is our eyes. In air, light travels in a straight line, just like the train along this track. To see an object, such as Chocolate Canyon, light needs to bounce off the object and then enter our eyes. If we put the object in water, light now has to travel through water and air to reach our eyes. It travels in a straight line through the water, but then bends a bit when it moves from the water into the air. This bending of light is called refraction. The light continues to travel in a straight line through the air and into our eyes, so we see the object even though it's underwater. As we increase the angle, the light continues to bend. Eventually, it bends so much that it doesn't move from the water into the air, but just bounces back into the water. This is called total internal reflection. The Ziploc bag that we put in the container of water had a tiny bit of air in it. If light hits the bag at this angle or from anywhere in this area, we get total internal reflection. The light bounces back into the water and doesn't bounce off the object in the bag, so we can't see what's in the bag. Now that we know how it works, here's three more ideas for you to try at home. The first idea is to make a black and white picture colorful. Just add a colored photo to a Ziploc bag and trace around the edges with a permanent marker. Whoa! The next idea is to write a secret message. Print out a piece of paper that contains a secret message surrounded by a lot of other letters. Add this to the Ziploc bag and carefully trace over the letters of the secret message. That is so cool! The last idea is my favorite. Making an invisibility cloak. Draw this cartoon on a piece of paper, add it to a Ziploc bag, and carefully draw over everything except for the invisibility cloak. It should look like this. Awesome! And that's how you make things disappear.